Aranmula in Thiruvananthapuram now, where a proposed international airport has set off quite a storm. The reason? This project will affect the 1600-year-old Parthasarathi Temple.
This area also happens to be listed as a heritage village under United Nations Development Programme norms. Naveed Nair gets us this report.
The story of violation began in 2011, when the then V.S. Achyutanandan government notified the heritage village as an industrial zone, an overnight decision to which last month the UPA government at the centre gave an environmental clearance. But even a section of the congressmen are now in doubt.
People have no way out but to question this environmental clearance obtained by concealing material facts before the National Green Tribunal only. And there will be continuous agitation of the local public.
Meanwhile, environmental activists in Aranmula allege that the environmental impact assessment study done for the airport was nothing but a sham.
If the environment ministry, the ministry's name is Forest and Environment, for what is the for what are they aim? The ministry is set up for the conservation of environment, protect the environment. Now they are destroying the environment.
It is now beyond doubt that the KGS project does involve shady land deals overlooking all environmental concerns. But there is something bigger brewing here. This is a 1600-year-old world-famous Parthasarathi temple. The very existence of this temple is at stake now.
For most temples across South India, the pole forms the essence, a symbol of its existence. But with an international airport planned hardly 500 meters away, the pole comes as a barrier. Locals are now convinced that the airport will do nothing but kill the temple and the traditions of Aranmula.
We are sure that they cannot touch this temple. But we are feared about the puja, daily rituals, our belief. We won't permit it.
While the Sangh Parivar has silently housed 500 men in houses in and around the temple, the CPM has meanwhile occupied the proposed site with its Adivasi families. All signs of a mass uprising.
You know, we already have three big international airports, plus another one is coming up at Kannur, and we don't want the fields of Aranmula to be destroyed. We don't want those hills to be destroyed, that wetland to be destroyed in the name of meaningless development for the benefit of a private company.
Actually, people in Aranmula wanted the project, but it is certain some vested interest who has got some wrong misgivings or misunderstandings about the project, that they are agitating against the project.
From January first week, the agitation is going to intensify, with civil society in Kerala cutting across all barriers, set to descend in Aranmula for a non-stop satyagraha. Real headaches ahead for the Oman Chandi government, which already has a 10% stake in the project. With Naveen Nair in Aranmula, Shujoy, Headlines Today.